This YCN segment is brought to you by New London Hospital, an affiliate of Dartmouth Hitchcock.
The Raiders suffered an early exit from last year's playoffs in the quarterfinals, while the Cavaliers won New Hampshire's Division II state championship for the first time in school history. Since then, some important players have graduated, but a number of key girls have also returned from both squads, which should result in high seeds for Lebanon and Hollis Brookline come March. To start off this big early season matchup, Hollis Brookline senior Elizabeth Atkinson passed down low to junior Amanda Gokhlowski, who managed to score despite contact for an and one. Her free throw missed, which then allowed Lebanon's junior Megan Gratigan to tie the game with a jumper from just behind the free throw line. The rest of the first quarter was very evenly matched as Hollis Brookline's Atkinson scored 4 points in the paint, and her teammate junior Christina Balsamo nailed a three. On the other side, Lebanon senior Anna Wolke and Gratigan each sunk their own long balls. By the end of 8 minutes, the hosts were up 13-11. Atkinson continued to be effective down low to begin the second quarter, as her teammates showed off their passing abilities. But the Cavaliers weren't able to gain any momentum, as Gratigan and Wolke continued to hit threes. Lebanon's freshman Catherine Cole scored her first varsity points, also with a three, which was the Raiders' fifth of the half. While Lebanon built as much as an 11-point lead, by the break, Hollis Brookline had cut that deficit down to just six. With the seconds ticking away, Balsamo stole the ball and passed up to sophomore Abby Magnuszewski, who managed to score up close with the foul. She wasn't able to hit the free throw, so at halftime, Lebanon led with a score of 27-21. To begin the third, Raiders' Becky Wright started to go off, as she scored 5 points from the floor and four from the free throw line for a game-leading total of 16 points. Combined with strong defense, she helped Lebanon get back on top by double digits. Anna Wolke was also key with assists and another three-pointer. By the time the fourth began, the hosts had built a 15-point lead, which they maintained throughout the rest of the game. Becky Wright added another 8 points during the last quarter, and her teammates senior Isabel Perez and sophomore Sally Rainey got on the scoreboard, as Lebanon went on to win with a final score of 54-28. Junior Rebecca Wright led all scorers with 24 points, and her teammate Anna Wolke was right behind her with 11. Lebanon as a team shot 10 for 19 from three-point range and allowed just 7 total points in the second half. After the game, we spoke with Raiders' longtime head coach Tim Kehoe, as well as Becky Wright and Sally Rainey, to hear what they had to say about such a big win.
Well, we played a really good team. I think our perimeter game really came up tonight, and we hit some big shots from the outside. And once we hit big shots on the outside, that kind of freed up Becky to do her thing on the high post and low post area. And if we continue to hit shots, teams are going to double down like that. We're going to make them pay. So I thought we had good composure. I thought early we got in foul trouble a little bit. Some young kids came in and did a nice job. And all in all, it's a great win. I mean, we play a really good team here, and we got 4 to 5 starters back, and they won the championship. And we play a really good Hanover team. And from all accounts, most coaches picked Hollis or Hanover to win the whole thing. So you never get too high on a win this early in the season, but it was a good win for our program, and it was a good win for our kids as far as just realizing that, you know, if they play hard every night, that they can compete with anybody. I thought Anna Wolke played exceptionally well. I thought she stepped up, hit some big shots. We wanted her to increase her range this year, and she stepped out and hit some big threes. And I think Megan Gratigan's a good stabilizer for us. She runs the point really well. She hit some big shots tonight too. But I think when she's on the floor, we're a little more calm. We run things exceptionally well. And Sally's just a workhorse for us. Sally's the one inside that, you know, does all the dirty things for us that makes things happen. Dive on the floor, get the rebounds. So it's a great team effort. All in all, I thought we played really well for a first game.
I think tonight we did really well offensively. You know, we're a tight team. We played well last year together, so we kind of know how each other plays. We just kind of mesh very well together. I think the key point that this game was to just stay together defensively. We've been struggling with that because we're bigger. You know, we're not as fast as other teams. So we're still trying to find our defensive like spot, and I think tonight we did really well with that. And like we talked on defense, we like told each other like what was happening. Honestly, I think everybody who stepped on the floor really played amazing. It's tough to beat the defending champs, you know. It always is. That's how it is. Even the girls like on the bench, you know, they make our games. They practice with us. They push us. So everybody who is on our team contributes to us winning.
I think our team did really well doing what we worked on in practice, which was essentially we got in as much as we could in this preseason, and I think that that really worked in our favor because we were able to switch it up on them, run different plays, push the ball off the floor, and really play our game. Becky obviously goes without saying. She is amazing. I think she held our team together defensively and offensively, and I also think Anna Wilkie, Megan Gratton, and Izzy Perez really stepped up and filled the shoes that they needed to fill tonight. Well, Mr. Keough says in the beginning of the season, never take any win too hard, never take any loss too hard, and I think that's what we got to do. We have to keep our cool. We play a really good team on Tuesday, Hanover, and obviously this is a really big win, but I think it's one that we came in knowing that we could get, and we got it.
Lebanon starts off their season at 1-0, while Hollis Brookline falls to 0-1. Both teams have a ton of talent with depth, which should result in high seeds for both the Raiders and Cavaliers come playoff time.